Good morning, children. This is S.K. Srivastava, your social science teacher. As we all know that the schools are closed, that's why we are here to provide you online classes. So today I am going to start first chapter of geography, India, size and location. This is the very first chapter of your book. In this chapter, we are going to discuss about the size, the location of India. So, see this map. India is entirely located in the northern hemisphere. This is latitudinal extent 8 degree 4 minute north to 37 degree 6 minute north latitude. Longitudinal extent is 68 degree 7 minute east to 97 degree 25 minute east. This is 82 degree 30 minute east, known as standard meridian of India, passing through Mirzapur near Allahabad. When we talk about the, so this is all about the location of India. Clear? This is the latitudinal extent, this is the longitudinal extent, this is north south extent of India, this is east west extent of India. Now this is Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree north, which divides the country into two equal halves, the northern part and the southern part. So this is all about the location of India. Now come to the size. India is the seventh largest country of the world after Russia, Canada, USA, Brazil, Australia, China. Clear? Sequence wise it is Russia, Canada, USA, China, Brazil, Australia. These are the six other countries which are bigger than India. So India is the seventh largest country of the world as far as area is concerned. Its total geographical area is 3.28 million square kilometer. 3.28 million square kilometer, which is 2.4% of the world's total geographical area. Which is 2.4% of the world's total geographical area. Let us talk about the land boundary of India. India has a land boundary of 15,200 kilometers. Total land boundary. Land boundary 15,200 kilometers. Coastal length is, and what is the total coastal length of India? Coastal length is 7516 kilometers. So let us see, total geographical area of India is 3.28 million square kilometer, which is 2.4% of the world's total geographical area. This is the land boundary, 15,200 kilometer. Coastal length is 7516 kilometer. Now see, India is a very vast country with some distinct physical characteristics. Towards the north, here lies the Great Himalayas, which extend from the north to northeast and towards northwest. Here it is Bay of Bengal. This is Arabian Sea, and towards the south it is Indian Ocean, which provide it a very unique location. Southern part, which is known as peninsular region, this region from here to here, This region is known as peninsular India. What do you mean by peninsula? A piece of land which is surrounded by water from three sides is known as peninsula. Clear? Here it is Andaman and Nicobar group of island. Here it is Lakshadweep island. Now, see, this is the latitudinal extent from 8 degree 4 minute north to 37 degree 6 minute north. Now, what is the impact of this latitudinal extent? Latitudinal extent influences the duration of day. It influences the duration of day when we move from south towards the north. Here I would like to discuss one important question, that is difference between duration of day and night is hardly felt at Kanyakumari, but it is not so in Jammu and Kashmir, in Kashmir region. As we know that this is Kanyakumari, this is the southernmost part of India, which lies very near to equator. So here the duration of day and night almost remains the same. But as we move from Kanyakumari towards Kashmir, this difference is very clearly felt. This difference can be observed very clearly. Now we will discuss something about the India and the world. Here this is all about India's location and size. Now here one more thing. This 82 degree 30 minute east known as standard meridian of India. Why it is taken as standard meridian for India? Because there is a time lag of 2 hours from between Arunachal Pradesh and Gujarat. Arunachal Pradesh, which is the easternmost part of the country, receives sun's rays first of all, and here it takes 2 more hours. Suppose if it is 6 a.m. in Arunachal Pradesh, in Gujarat it is still 4 a.m. So, because of this time lag, there are confusions. So, to avoid these confusions, 82 degree 30 minute east is taken as standard meridian for India. The time along this meridian passing through Mirzapur has been taken as the standard time for the whole country. That's why the watches show the same time. Is it clear? Now let us discuss about India and the world. As we all know, India is located in the center between East Asia and West Asia. See, this is the picture. It is very clear what is the location of India on the map of the world. Now, India is located between East Asia and West Asia. The Indian landmass has a central location between the East and West Asia. It is a southward extension of the Asian continent. The Trans-Indian Ocean routes, which connect the countries of Europe in the west and the countries in the east. Asia provide a strategic central location to India. No other country in the world have such a big coastline as India has. No other country in the world has this much length of coast. Now, India's contact with the world. Because of the unique location of India at the head of the Indian Ocean, India has very old cultural and commercial relations with many countries of the world. India's contacts with the world have continued through the ages, but her relationship through the land routes are much older than her maritime routes. Than her maritime routes means people used to move from one country to from India to other countries through the land routes. Now, how these land routes play a very important role. Land routes have contributed in the exchange of ideas and commodities since ancient times. There is exchange of goods, ideas between different countries with India through these land routes. The ideas of Upanishads, the idea of Panchatantra, all the ideas of Upanishads, Ramayana, Panchatantra, the Indian numerals and the decimal system thus could reach many parts of the world with the help of these land routes. The spices, muslin and other merchandise were taken from India to different parts of the world. India also imports a lot of things. For example, the influence of Greek sculpture and architectural style of Dove from West Asia can be seen in different parts of the country. Now, the maritime contacts means contacts of India with the other countries of the world through oceans. Indian Ocean helped India to establish close cultural and commercial contacts with the countries of West as well as of East equally. With the opening of Suez Canal, the distance between Europe and India reduced by 7,000 kilometers, which helped us a lot. Now, India's neighbors. India occupies a very important strategic position in South Asia. India shares its land boundary with Pakistan and Afghanistan in the northwest. Here is Pakistan and Afghanistan in the northwest. Nepal, Bhutan, China, Tibet in the north. Myanmar and Bangladesh in the east. Our southern neighbors across the sea consist of two island countries. They are Maldives and Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is separated by a narrow channel of sea formed by the Pak Strait. Gulf of Mannar and Maldives islands are situated to the south of Lakshadweep islands. India has a strong geographical and historical link with her neighbors. So, children, this is all about the location, size, India and the world, or India's contact with the world and India's neighbors. Let us just conclude the chapter with some important points. First of all, India is the seventh largest country of the world. Total geographical area is 3.28 billion square kilometer, which is 2.4% of the world. Now, at last, India is often called Indian subcontinent. Why? Because it has a distinctive identity from the rest of the Asia, which I discussed earlier. Hope you have enjoyed this. Thanks. We will meet again with another chapter.